Dear friends, now let's talk about our second inventory control technique, which is XYZ analysis. Now, XYZ analysis is a technique which is used in inventory management to categorize items based on their demand variation. Now, it is different from ABC analysis. How? Because in ABC analysis, we categorized items based on their value. But in XYZ analysis, it helps businesses to identify and manage items based on the demand patterns. So the optimization of inventory can be much better if we considered the demand patterns. Now, before we understand more about XYZ analysis, just understand it is very important that ABC analysis is not enough for better inventory planning, because you may find some items in A class inventory just because their value is too high, but their demand pattern is very less. So it could be possible that some industrial machineries whose value is very high and they are part of A class material, but they are needed hardly once in a few years or hardly in, you know, certain circumstances. So irrespective of its value, it is also important to understand demand pattern, and that closes loop when we use XYZ analysis. Now, some smart supply chain professionals often use ABC and XYZ analysis in combination frequently so that they have a better and efficient inventory planning strategies. Now, we will see ABC and XYZ combination in later part, but now let's understand only XYZ analysis. Now, in XYZ analysis, items are classified into three categories. First is X, second is Y, and third is Z category. Now, what is X category? Now, X category products are products which are having almost a fixed demand and they have very less variation in their demand pattern. So, X class items are basically those products which are regularly required in a business at some up and down in quantities, but they are regularly required. Such products are showing well forecast accuracies and they can be easily forecasted also. On other side, Y class products are products which shows slightly more variance in demand compared to the X class items, and there is much significant up and down trends in Y class inventory. So Y class can be also a seasonal demand products, and that's why they are showing, you know, much demand variation compared to X class, and it is very hard to forecast such products easily. On other side, Z class products are the products with major variation of demand, and these products are used rarely in the business. And these products may not be used for a long time or for certain periods. And that is simply the XYZ analysis. So in X class, we have seen that demand is much stable. In Y class, demand has more variation compared to X class. And in Z class, there is a sporadic variation in the demand pattern of the product. So this is, now if we plot XYZ analysis in a line graph, you can see that, let's consider there are three products. So there are three products which are series 1 wall, series 2 wall, and series 3 wall. So if you see, series 1 is basically X category of material whose demand is stable throughout the year. Series 2 wall is basically Y category of product whose demand has little more variation compared to X class product. And if you see series 3 wall here, it has sporadic demand variation compared to X, Y, and that's why it is part of Z class of material. Now, as far as use of XYZ analysis is concerned, the very first use is inventory optimization. Now, we know that we are categorizing inventory based on demand prediction or demand pattern of the product. And because of that, business can fine-tune their inventory strategies. They can employ different forecasting models and inventory control methods for each of the product line, and which will actually help to have a optimal stock levels and minimizing the risk of excess or obsolete inventory. It also has a use in demand planning. So in XYZ analysis, we understand the demand variation of products, and that's why it allows to allocate resources effectively to develop more accurate demand forecast. Now in this situation, especially for Z items, these are highly unpredictable demand patterns. So we can give special focus on forecasting Z items and understanding more insights of their demand patterns so that their excess or obsolete inventory in future will be minimum. The third use of XYZ analysis is to manage the suppliers. Now we all know that we have a demand characteristics studied in XYZ analysis. So businesses can work closely with their suppliers to establish appropriate agreements for X category of products, because these are frequently running products, and such agreements like, you know, vendor managed inventory or let's say price contracts, negotiations can be much useful for the business. On other side, Z class items may have volatile demand, and to avoid any stockouts or any supply chain disruptions, having alternate source of suppliers can be also one of the strategy that companies can use through XYZ analysis. So in a summary, XYZ analysis provides valuable insights for the demand variation.